everybody. This is Major Pandemic, and in this video, I'm going to do a quick, very, very quick show and tell on how to build an AR-15 from parts, from a parts kit. In this case, I'm using a DPMS Oracle kit. I have a Phase 5 compensator on the end, and it's actually entry muzzle brake, and then I also have a few other parts that I'll get into. The first thing we're doing is lubing out all the parts, throw a little rim oil in there, and toss them around. Have a mega lower here, really nice billet lower. I have all my parts set up, and in this video I'm really trying to show that you don't need a bunch of specialty parts just to assemble an AR. A couple of things you do need, though. You do need at least a castle wrench. Really, an armorer's tool would be helpful. Obviously, having all your upgrades available at this point would save you a lot of time of redos and so forth. And first off, we're going to go ahead and take the trigger, and we're going to attach the trigger spring. Polishing is really going to help. This is just a leather strap with some paste. You want to do that about 10 times on the back side of the trigger. Go ahead and attach the trigger spring, or the hammer spring on the hammer, and the spring, the cone-shaped spring on the disconnector, and so forth. And you want to go and polish the back of that hammer as well about 10 times. That's going to give you a nice, strong, easy trigger pull. First thing we want to do is go ahead and put in the selector switch, and go ahead and put in the detent, then the spring and the grip. And the easiest thing to do here is go ahead and just push that grip down straight, and usually the friction will hold it in, and then you can go ahead and put in the bolt. Kind of wiggle the bolt around in there with the lock washer, screw it down tight, and then you should be ready to go. So that's the first thing that needs to be done. And so make sure everything works. Goody. Alright, next thing we want to do is go ahead and put in the trigger. And one of the big secrets here in putting together your lower parts is to use a punch. So you basically put the punch in instead of the pin from the right to the left, so that you can insert all your pins correctly from the left going to the right. And that's going to really help you pull everything together. Your pin should go in the non-edged, non-groove side first, and that go in, and then obviously you go ahead and put the hammer assembly on top of that. Now, one thing you do want to note is, whenever you're kind of driving those final punches in with a hammer, you want to be really, really careful, because really the pin should go in without any extra force. And sometimes they're just a little tight, but if they're not aligned right, then you're kind of going to start damaging things. Next thing we want to do is go ahead and install the magazine button and release. We'll pop the release in, the spring, screw the button down as far as you can get it, and then at that point what you want to do is push down the button, rotate the mag catch a couple times, and then you usually need to use something like a mask or a tape cover tool to go ahead and push that button in on a little bit further and screw the catch down until it's even with the button. I'm going to show you that I went too far and you had to back up and everything else, but it's easy enough to figure out. Once it's in there, it stays. Now, the only I would say, having an armorer's tool and a split ring pair of pliers is going to make this thing work a lot better. So at this point, as far as the overall assembly, especially the barrel, goes, next thing we're going to do is go ahead and assemble the front pivot pin. And what you want to do is go ahead and put in the spring, go ahead and put in the detent, and then again use that punch to go ahead and hold down that detent, and so you can put in the pivot pin. And you might want to use pliers for the detent. I did. Makes it a little easier. Safety glasses, I can't say enough, you need to be wearing these things, because these little parts do start flying around the room, you start cussing and swearing. So and sometimes they end up in your eye and you're really cussing and swearing. Next thing we want to do is go ahead and put in the rear takedown pin. Go ahead and put in that pin first, go ahead and put in the detent, go ahead and put in the spring, and then we're going to go ahead and attach the buffer tube and The rear plate, instead of the rear plate, I'm using a Phase 5 Tactical all steel Revo plate. And what that does is it rotates 45 degrees each way. It's a really nice single point sling mount. And next what we're going to want to put in is the buffer retention pen and spring. Go ahead and put that in. And we'll screw the buffer tube down about another turn there until it pops and locks in place with that pin. All keyed in, nice and straight. The buffer tube's nice and straight at this point. And then what we need to do is just make sure, as we're tightening down that castle nut ever so slowly, that we're not pinching that spring. We have it put in correctly. And so, a couple of the things here. I'm obviously running through this pretty quick, and I'm going to go on and off screen a couple times just because some of these things need to be done on a workbench, and I can't do them on camera. So what I'm doing is just kind of straightening out that rear takedown spring, tightening up the castle nut. At this point, if you want to go ahead and stake the castle nut, you can. I'm not a big fan of that. Next thing you want to do is go ahead and put in the buffer spring. And just a note on the end, go ahead and put in the buffer, and it just pops in, and you're in good shape, and it's held in with the buffer tube spring catch. And then you got everything going except a bolt release. And so that'll be the next piece. Now, whenever you're doing the kits, obviously you want to make sure you're taping off all the parts, but as an example, the bolt, the buffer itself, a lot of times it's hidden in back of the stock, so you kind of want to check around. A lot of times you'll pull these kits apart and then realize, oh, it's stuck in the stock. You want to go ahead and apply a tape to any of your pliers and any other tools that you're doing, just to avoid any bright white scrapes down the side of a beautiful billet, mega lower in this case. And so what I'm doing is I'm putting in that pin, the bolt catch pin that holds it in. I'm putting it just enough so that I'm not trying to put it in while I'm trying to hold everything else in there. So you get it in just so it's flush with the inside, and then at that point then you can tap it in with a punch after you get everything in there, or you can go ahead and use your pliers. In the case, I'm using the Phase 5 Tactical ambidextrous bolt catch, so I'm going to have to use a punch to go ahead and drive it in versus being able to do it with a pair of pliers, but it does give me ambidextrous control of the bolt catch and bolt release. And so now we've got the bolt catch buffer and spring. Just a note there, you're going to have two small short springs in the kit. The straight spring should be for the bolt catch release. The tapered one should be for the disconnector on the trigger. And so what I'm doing is pulling off all the tape here, and now at this point we have a fully functional lower. And what I'll do is just put the receiver on here just to make sure it fits. Yep. All right, great. Now we're not going to use the trigger guard because the Mega has a built-in trigger guard. So what we're going to do is I'm going to put together the bolt and carrier. Go ahead and throw the bolt into the carrier about a 10 o'clock position. Go ahead and position the all the pins, and it's pretty self-explanatory. I just kind of want to show this. Most of them show them complete, or ship them complete, but in the case of DPMS, they sent it complete. So you don't have to worry about assembling the bolt. Next thing is go ahead and put together the handguard retainer, the spring, and the split ring. Now the split ring, again, this is where the right tool for the right job makes things easier, but I just happen to have a set of really, really fine needle nose pliers that worked. And so what you want to do is just kind of test fit this. You're going to kind of put it together, make dry fit it, make sure everything goes together. Yep. All right, great. Wipe everything down. And then usually what I like to do is go ahead and apply a little bit of lube and retest fit it again. This is obviously one of the most critical junctures in the entire gun itself. And you really want to make sure you've got everything exactly the way it should be. So I'll go ahead and test fit this again, and in fact I'll go ahead and crank this on. Again, an armor's wrench would really, really help having the right tool to go ahead and tighten down that barrel nut. But I get away with, some people will use, if they're doing a free float tube, they'll just go ahead and use a strapper wrench, and you don't even need a bolt nut wrench. But in this case, I'm using a castle nut wrench, which also works. Not as well, but it works. And it's a $10 tool versus a $30 tool. And so what you want to do here is basically tighten that nut down, the barrel nut down, really to the point, just so you got it hand tight, and then go just far enough with tightening it up. What I'm showing here is, I like to go ahead and protect the thread, so I go ahead and put on the crush washer and the, in this case, the entry brake from Phase Via Tactical, and tighten that up. And you want to make sure you clock that correctly. Sometimes you have to flatten that washer out a little bit with a hammer. So we're back at putting the barrel on. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to lube everything. I'm going to lube the inside of the receiver. I'm going to lube the outside of the threads. I'm going to put a little bit of lube on the outside of the barrel that goes into the receiver. And you want to, for the thread perspective, you just want to make sure that you're preventing any seizing between that barrel nut and those aluminum threads, because at some point you might want to pull this apart. And as far as the barrel goes, you don't have to do this. I like to do it. I just think it's a good practice. Just make sure there's nothing that's just going to seize together. And you want to use a good quality grease, so a synthetic grease like the Sentry Solutions High Slip Grease is great stuff. Works out really, really well, and lasts a long time, very heat resistant. And one of the pieces that you want to make sure you're doing is you're lining up that the little half moons in the barrel nut so that your gas tube can go from the gas block all the way back into the receiver. And so usually that takes a little strong arming. In this case, I'm just going to show I tap this gingerly with a hammer. That's not what happened. I put it in a vise with a piece of wood stuck in the bottom of the receiver, and so I didn't scrape anything up, and then gently tapped it with a hammer and the wrench. When I got back, obviously I was showing you there, I inserted the gas tube from the rear, and it really helps you kind of line it up when you're on the vise and so forth. And now what I'm going to do is I've loosened up all the screws on the gas block, and putting it all together, sliding it through. Sometimes you have to kind of move that split ring and the spring retainer inside there that holds on the guards to make sure everything goes through. But once you get it, it's not a tough task. Next thing we want to do is go ahead and put in the gas tube pin that holds the gas tube on the gas block. And I found that if you go ahead and put a really small hex wrench through there, and this is really tough to show on a video because it's tough to do when you're not on the bench, when you're on a in this case wire rack that is my little video studio. But you get the idea. And so what I want to show here is the Mega receiver actually has a tensioning pin that can screw in. And so if you have a little play between your upper and lower receiver, and you're one of those people that kind of bugs, Mega has the ability to adjust that tension. So you can, regardless of what the fit is between the upper and lower, you can always adjust that tension and put it on there. And what I'm showing here is I'm just kind of tightening up the muzzle brake, making sure that's good and it's keyed in correctly. You've got primary holes. Kind of tips here. This is the piece of wood I used on the receiver, on the upper and lower receiver when I was doing anything on the vise. Always use a punch. using little Allen wrenches and so forth to align things and lube, the proper lubes and so forth, always makes the job a little bit easier. So here I have the final rifle. Very happy with how it turned out. I'll go ahead and do a review on this rifle so you have the full review, but I want to show you a quick rundown on how to assemble an AR. That's soup to nuts. Thanks a lot. See you on the range.